we are going to, over and over and over, just practice this, practice this, practice this today. So, remember a graph? What's a graph made of?
X and Y axis.
Dots.
Dots, or points. Points, to be more mathematical about it. Points. They're made of points. Okay? Here's a point, there's a point, there's a point, there's a point, there's lots of points. There's an infinite number of points to choose from. They're all over the place. Some of them are out poorly. They don't look like points, but they should be points. Okay. Now, those points that I just threw up there randomly, they may have happened to belong to the graph of this function, and maybe not. And rather than just guessing randomly and seeing if they fit, we'll find the points more strategically and put them down. So we start with a strategy that has been explained before, and let's see if you remember what would be the easiest thing to do. Zero. What do you mean by zero? What is zero?
X.
X is zero. Let's plug in zero for X. Zero for X. Ooh. I'll write the work down, but you'll see we don't really need to write this work down every time. 2/5 times zero minus two. But what's anything times zero?
Zero.
You just get zero minus two, which is two. So I didn't really have to bother writing all that work down, right? Because I know that this is going to be zero. I'm going to subtract this, and 0 minus 2 is negative 2. Okay? There's a point right there. 0, negative 2. Well, now this next part is just a little bit more challenging. We're going to plug another value in for x, but it's not as easy to just, like, zeros. Throw 0 in there. It's not always 0. It's different for each equation. Anybody think of what number I want to plug in for x? So that I don't plug a fraction in and I don't get a fraction out. Sit.
5.
How about 5? Let's see what happens with 5. How do we multiply fractions? Talked about Friday.
Straight across.
Straight across. 2 times 5. 5 times 1. And here is the nice thing, because 10 divided by 5 is
2.
We plugged in not a fraction and got out not a fraction. So we plugged in 5 and we got out what?
0.
Very good. 2 minus 2 is 0. Now we have 2 points. One of them is right there, 0, negative 2. The other one is 5, 0. Right there. There we go. Nice point. How many points did I just plot?
2.
An infinite number of points. Okay, right? I put 2 down to start with, and then an infinite number. All of the rest of the points, at least in this window here. Because I can go infinitely to the right or the left, and I can see a graph forever and ever. But I also plotted an infinite number of points right in here. We're going to do what for this function? Plug in 0 for x. Don't really need to show all that work, right? Because 5 halves times 0 is what?
0.
And plus 1 is?
1.
Look at that.
That was
cool.
Whoa.
That was
a what value should we plug in for x? Right? We're going to take 5 halves, we're going to multiply by something and add 1. What would you like to plug in there so that we get that same nice divide and you get a whole number. 5?
5.
No. 6.
4.
Any number smaller than 4 that you can think of?
3. 2.
How about 2?
1.
Let's try 2. Okay, 5 times 2 is 10. Over 2. Is 10 divisible by 2?
Yes.
Are you surprised that 10 is divisible by 2?
No.
No, because what did we do? We put a number here that made sure when we multiply these two numbers together, we get a number that is divisible. By 2.
Which is 5.
And 10 divided by 2 is 5. And here we have this plus 1 that we're going to throw in there. So we plug in a 2, everything cancels down to a whole number. 5 plus 1 is 6. 0, 1, 2, 6, and the infinite rest of points. Okay, so the first thing, the easiest thing we do is what?
Plug a number in.
Which number would be the easiest one?
Zero.
Zero. Every time zero is the easiest thing, okay? So zero. Every time zero for every equation. But then we plug in another number, and it's not always the same. How do we pick this number? For this one, we picked 5. For this one, we picked 2. When I look at the next equation that I'm going to graph, what am I going to look for? Ready?
Things that can be multiplied by each other to make.
It doesn't have to be even, right? Because this
doesn't make a decimal.
So that when we simplify the fraction that we get, we don't get a decimal.
Yeah.
Like that, yeah?
Or a fraction.
So how do we make sure that that happens with this fraction? If we're gonna multiply by 5/2, what kind of number do we plug in here so that we know we come out with a whole number?
Is there a multiple of 5 and 2?
Should it be a multiple of 5 and 2? We didn't plug this. I'm talking about the number that it plugged in was 2.
Multiple of just 5?
2 is not a multiple of 5. What number should I put here?
10?
No, we put 2 there. That's not 10. Why 2? Because of the denominator. Because the denominator is going to be doing the dividing, right? And so when we multiply straight across and we get this numerator, we want this numerator to be divisible by the denominator of 2. So if we put the denominator, the same number that is the denominator there, then we're definitely going to be divisible by 2. In this one, what's another number different from 2 that I can plug in? And in this step, I'm going to have a number that's divisible by 2. 4, plug in 4 is another good one. 4. So 5 times 4 is 20. 20 divided by 2 is 10, plus 1 is 11, so 4 in gives us 11 out. 4, 11, oh, that's a pretty good graph. It's really close to being on the right point. Okay, so I'm going to show you four equations, four set of x and y axes. And all I want you to do, first of all, is for all four of them, let's just do that number one easiest thing, which was to do what?
Zero.
Zero for x.
Zero.
So just do all four of them, plug zero in for x. Okay? Every one of these four, plug in zero. Alright, so for this one, we're just plugging zero in for x in all of these equations. If I plug in zero for this one, what do I get for y?
You get -5.
Get -5. 3/4 times 0. What's anything times 0?
0.
Minus 5. 0 minus 5 is, someone say it out loud. 0 minus 5.
-5.
Okay, if I plug in 0 for x here, 6 times 7 times 0 is? Is?
0.
Minus 1.
-1.
Plug in 0 here, we get what?
+3.
+3. Plug in 0 here, we get?
+9.
+9. That was what I wanted you to do for all three of those. That I'm just having you practice what I might call the first step of graphing. We'll go over this later for a few days from now, but this is called slope-intercept form. Okay. So when it looks like it's in slope-intercept form, y equals a number times x plus some other number, that number might negative as well. Let's plug in 0 for x. It's the easiest thing I could do first. It gives me a point really quickly. Here's the point for this guy here. 0, negative 1, 0, 3, and 0, 9.
Put them on the same graph and they make a straight line.
Of course they do. They're all on the y-axis, right? So they would. But they're not the same graph. So we do not want to connect these points with each other, right? Because they're all independent of each other. All right, next. We're gonna do this one where I help you mostly, okay? Or maybe you'll just jump in there and handle it. This one you're gonna do more on your own, and these last two we'll do individually, and then we'll do them as a class. So, in this guy here, I need another point. The easiest thing I can choose to plug in for x, so that this will happen, 3/4 times some number minus 5. I know that I'm going to put a number over 1. I'm going to get something over 4. So I'd like this number to be what?
12. Something divisible.
Yeah, generally something divisible by 4, which 12 is a number that's divisible by 4, which I'll get if I plug in 4. Right? And so we do get 12. 12 divided by 4 is 3. The nice thing here is I plugged in 4, which is a whole number. And the result of that is a whole number. Minus 5, we get negative 2. Right?
Yep.
And again, where you give me a little more help here, what number would I like to plug in for x in this case?
7,
14. 14 would work, 7 would work, 21 would work, negative 7, negative 14, 28 would work. All of these numbers are what?
Divisible by 7.
Divisible by 7, multiples of 7. So the easiest multiple of 7 I could choose?
7.
It's nice and small as it can be. 6 sevenths times 7 over 1, minus 1, 42 over 7, minus 1. 42 divided by 7 is 6, minus 1. 7, 5. So we've got 2 points there, we've got 2 points. Oh, I didn't graph this one, 4, negative 2. Okay? That's what I want you to do for these other two as well.
Okay?
Now you have to decide what number to plug in for x. Do that individually, please. All right, this guy down here, we're going to take 5/8 and multiply it by the number that we plug in for x. The number that we plug in for x, we would like this to happen. I would like to plug in it over 1. We'd like to plug in a number over 1 because that means we're plugging in a whole number, not a fraction. We'd like to plug in whole numbers, not fractions, if we can.
8.
And we'd like this to be divisible by 8, which means we should put an 8 there. In order for this to be a number that's divisible by 8, it needs this number. It needs to have a factor of 8, so we put a factor of 8 in there. 5 times 8 is 40. 40 divisible by 8?
5.
Would you divide by 8? Patience.
3 is 8.
Allie over there. Okay, so we put, what did we put in for x?
8.
8, right? It's right there. 8, we plugged in. 8. What did we get out?
8.
We also got out 8.
8.
8. 8. 8. 8.
That's 8. 8. It's like, right there. Man, it's hard to see.
Okay.
Hold up the line, just trying to see where that point was.
Okay, in this equation, we're going to take negative 4/3. Negative, remember it's a negative. We're going to multiply negative 4/3 by whatever goes right there. And we would like this to be, it's going to be negative. Well, maybe it is. It's going to be over 3 for sure, right? Mm-hmm. So we'd like this number to be divisible by 3, so?
Negative 3.
What you going to put 3 or negative 3 in there?
Negative 3.
Okay, so negative 3. What's a negative times a negative?
Positive.
Positive. So negative 4 times negative 3 is positive 12. Now, if you plugged in a positive 3, you should get a negative 12. Right? But either way, it's working out just fine. 12 divided by 3 is 4, plus 9 is 13. So what did we plug in for x? Negative 3. What did we get out for y?
13.
Now what if we change it? What if we change it to a positive 3? Same thing? Not exactly the same. We put in a positive 3. What's a negative 4 times a positive 3?
Negative
12. And what's negative 12 divided by positive 3?
Negative 4.
What's negative 4 plus 9?
Negative 5.
Negative 4 plus 9 brings us into the positive 5. So there, depending on who you are, you might have gotten one of those 2 points. And because we looked at both of them, now we have 3 points here. 0, 9, negative 3, 13, which we'll try our best. 11, 12, 13. 3, 5. Not a big surprise, those 3 points are all in a line, a straight line. We wrap in the lines, lots of lines. There we go. Over here, I already plotted that second point. There's our line connecting these 2 points, and we'll just continue it in the other direction forever. This one too. What do you notice about that last line down here? Brandon?
Doesn't go through the middle of the thing.
The what?
It's positive, all positive. Right?
What do you mean, it's all, the last one's all positive, you're saying?
Yeah, with all the points on there.
Well, these are negative down here.
Oh.
Anybody notice anything different about that fourth line compared to the other three?
It goes what?
It goes, kind of depends on how you say it goes down, you say it goes left, right? So if we think of it this way, from left to right, what does this line do?
Going right.
Well, yeah. So I'm going from left to right. It's going up as I go from left to right. If I go from left to right, this line goes?
Down.
Left to right.
Up.
From left to right, we're going up. From left to right, we're going up. From left to right, we're going?
Down.
Down. Right. So if we like kind of standardize how we're looking at it, we don't get all these different things like what's going left, it's going down, it's going up. If we say from left to right, then we say it's definitely going down. As you go from left to right, you're going down. If I was on the line and I was walking from the left to the right, I'd be walking downhill. Okay? Why does that happen? Why does this one go down and these ones don't? They all go up.
Because they're not negative.
Because they're not negative. That one's negative. What's negative about this one? What's negative about this? Negative 4/3.
Yeah.
Negative 4/3. Right? Because as I plug in a bigger number for x, I just get, you know, I subtract more and more and more. I lose as I plug in a bigger x. For this one, the bigger number I plug in for x, the bigger this number gets. The bigger number I plug in for x, the bigger this number gets. The bigger x is, the bigger this is. But the bigger x is here, meaning positive. Actually, the smaller this is, because negative numbers are smaller than positive numbers. Just keeps going down and 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 down. Negative and negative and negative. Just goes plummeting into the negative forever and ever and ever. Okay? So this is what we call having a positive rate, positive slope. Positive rate, positive slope, positive rate, positive slope, negative rate, negative slope. Okay. Now it's time to work on homework, you think?
Hey.
This is something we've done before, but I want to review it quickly. Okay, you feel free to just raise your hand if you think you have a story that fits.
All right.
Yeah, I've done this before. Not with this exact equation, but we have done it before. I'm sure you got a story.
$2 a day.
$2 a day.
X is the day.
And what?
$4.
Oh, X is the day is what I can catch. X is the days. And 4 is what?
Extra dollars.
4 extra dollars? That's perfect. $4 actually, yeah. And so Y, what would Y represent?
Total money.
Total money that we earn or whatever. Okay? Now $2 a day is not a big amount of money per day, but it works. Does explain this equation, all right? And so if you'll recall from our discussion about these stories last time, the important thing about this guy here is that we read something like per in there. $2 per day, 2 miles per hour, 2 meters per second, all right? What we call a rate of change. Rate of change. Okay. Meaning that as we plug in more x, like a bigger x, like more days, well, the amount of money changes. That's why it's a rate of change. It's changing. Now this $4 is just an extra $4. It happens one time. It does not happen every day. It does not happen every hour. It's just four. Extra four. $4, four extra of whatever your story is, you would have to incorporate some kind of a four extra somethings for reason whatsoever, really. Okay? And this guy here would be a rate. So let's bring this one up. How about this story? You can come up with a story for this equation.
There were 5 sailors that boarded each day. 2 died. How many sailors are there?
That's perfect. 2 sailors per day get on this ship. 2 die. Right? And so how many sailors total after what?
Death. All right. After the 5 boards.
Well, it changed, right? The number of sailors can change depending on
X.
X is the number of what?
Sailors.
5 was the number of sailors per day.
Right.
So X is the number of sailors.
Days.
Days, yes, X, after X days. Right, so Y is how many sailors there are after X days. Okay, so you've incorporated the important parts, a rate. Right? A rate and a one-time loss of some amount. Okay? So 2 sailors die. All right, we're starting off, we can kind of think of it as like we're starting out 2 sailors down. All right, so after one day, how many sailors are on there?
3,
right? Because we lost the 2. Right? 5 for the first day, but the 2 were lost, so 3. But after that, after we incorporate that loss of 2, it's not like it happens every day, right? So the next day we get 5 more, so we're up to 8, right? And we're up to 13, and on it goes. Keep adding on 5 every day. Good. We start out with a negative amount, in a sense, and we have a rate of 5. Let's look at this last guy here. Think about that last one. Lose $6 per day. I like it. X is days. So let me pick right up on that. The rate needs to be negative, so there needs to be a way for it to go down, right?
Yeah.
Every day that goes by, we have less. That's what we call a negative rate. If we look at this last graph right here, look at that. That's a graph of a negative rate. It goes down as time goes on, the amount goes down. What was the 96? So you just, somebody throws $96 in your face, right, to get 96.
Cool. I think that.
It's a positive amount, $96 added for some reason. A bonus, because you're just really good looking, just give you $96, right? But after that, you start to lose $6 every, what did we say, day? Every day you lose $6. Okay. We can also think of it as like we can think of this as like an account. Are you listening? An account that money comes out of, like a prepaid cell phone thing. Right? You just does anybody in here do that? You buy a card with minutes on it. You put the minutes on, right? You pay $96, let's say, and then instead of $6 a day, probably $6 a minute, right? $6 a minute. Every minute you talk.
It is.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money.
Really bad. Maybe 6 cents a minute. Maybe we can change the cents a minute. And the $96 is like how much you started out in your account, and then it just goes down from there. Good. Those are great stories. We have rates. Okay, keywords here. Rate. Okay. And maybe like an initial value. Here our initial value was 4. We started out with 4 extra dollars. Here our initial rate was negative. Our initial value was negative 2. 2 sailors died. Here our initial value was 96. We started out with $96 for one reason or another. Okay. I just want to review that, recap that real quick, because we're going to do something tomorrow in rates. And we're going to refresh that in lines. Other than that, okay, if I want to graph this guy right here, what am I going to do? Brandon?
We're going to find out what M is 2, right?
What's that first thing that we can do? That's the easiest thing we can do. 0 for X. Okay. Alright. And if that guy is some kind of a fraction, like M equals some number over another number, then we're going to want to put what in there?
Numbers.
What number would we like to plug in for x if m is this fraction?
M.
Oh, b.
B, right? B is in the denominator. Remember how we plugged in numbers for x that were multiples of the denominator, divisible by the denominator? The denominator is b. Here, so we'll plug in. Oh, I used a bad letter because this is already b, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
right. About c and d. Sure, c over d. So we'll plug in B. Plug in 0, plug in whatever the denominator is. There you go, you're on your way.